Hello everyone, my name is Molly Weissman. I will be talking today's case study on the brand strength of the Disney Vacation Club. My advisor, James Shaw, is not here. Maybe he'll come in if he does. Oh, no? Come on, Nintendo. Pretend Nintendo's my advisor. Okay, so first we're going to talk a little bit about the background to let you know what the Vacation Club is. And kind of where I was, what I was thinking about whenever I got started with this project. Talk about the research questions that guided all the research I did, the literature that I looked into, my methodology, so what I actually did to do primary research, and then my analysis results and what I think can be implemented for further research. So the background. Everybody knows what Disney is. Raise your hand if you've never heard of Disney. Good. Okay. The Disney Vacation Club is essentially a timeshare program. So raise your hand if you've heard of a timeshare program. Raise your hand if you've been solicited to buy a timeshare program. Cool. So this is like that. This isn't a sales pitch, I promise you. And there's nothing free at the end, except knowledge. So the Vacation Club is a little bit different from the kind of like share a week in a condo thing that you might think of with a timeshare. Since it's a vacation club, it operates on a point system. So the real estate purchase that you make is a set number of points that you can then use to book nights at different hotel accommodations at the Walt Disney World Resort. So different larger companies have like a vacation club like this, like Marriott or Holiday Inn or things like that. So it's usually the bigger brands do more of a vacation club, whereas any old person could set up a timeshare program, kind of just, you know, try to get you to join. So the initial buy-in is per point, like I said, and the prices are always kind of changing with the market rates. Whenever they started selling vacation club points at Walt Disney World, it was like at $75. So you would buy, for example, points at $75 a point, and you might buy 100 points. So if you buy 100 points, the nights might cost 10 points a night. So then you can afford 10 nights with those 100 points. So that's how it works. So your initial investment is the $75 times the 100 points. And then there are also maintenance fees, just like any timeshare program. And for the Walt Disney World one, there's a lot of perks that come with it. So whenever you go to the presentation, they'll give you fast passes, and whenever you can you get into the parks sometimes early, or they have discounts and different perks for you. So that's a little bit about the program. So I had two big questions. Why do people do this? Why would people buy real estate to go on Disney vacations each year? It might seem like a kind of simple question, but there has to be a little bit more to it. So my first question is, why do people spend so much money? Kind of an ideal minimum would be like a $10,000 investment, all the way up to could be $50,000 or $100,000, depending on how many points you want to buy. And then you own, you know, $50,000 worth of Disney vacation. And then what kind of opportunities for brand extension might exist for the segment of consumers? So brand extension is kind of a marketing term that I'll go over with the literature, but the Disney Vacation Club is an example of a brand extension. So the Disney brand, you all said you're familiar with it, I'm sure you are. And Disney is a global leader in brand equity. So all those warm, fuzzy feelings you get when you watch Disney movies from your childhood, it's because Disney has created lots of positive experiences that you can associate with the brand. So that's the short answer for why people might be interested in buying into this. And the literature says that people will maintain a relationship with a brand that they have a positive association with at an increasing cost to themselves. So this is an example of the Disney vacations. So it costs more and more each year to go on these vacations and people are willing to shell out. And this group can be identified as the enthusiasts. So the people that are willing to shell out a large sum of money to go on these vacations every year. That's definitely a good example of it. Brand extension is how one of the ways that companies create new products, services, and experiences. So you use an existing brand to launch a new product. So you're using the brand equity that already exists to, you know, capture the positive associations that consumers already have with that brand. There are some risks associated with it. The main would be weakening the parent brand. So if you launch some product with the Disney brand and it's terrible, then that could weaken people's overall image of Disney. And like I said, the Disney Vacation Club is definitely an example of brand extension. So is Walt Disney World itself, you know, off of the initial animation studio that Walt created, and every other Disney thing you've ever heard of, they're all brand extensions from the initial idea of you know, the cartoons. And then timeshares. So like I said, the Disney Vacation Club is legally a timeshare program. So there are a lot of different laws that go along with that, regulations, restrictions on who can buy into it and how you can market them. But it is a real estate purchase. And I talked a little bit about what vacation clubs, how they differ from regular timeshares. But the main benefit for consumers is there is a cost savings for future vacations. So if you're going to go every year, you can save a significant amount of money on hotel accommodations if you buy into the program. And from Disney's perspective, so from a hotel accommodations management perspective, hotel rooms are perishable. So meaning if they're not sold each night, you don't make any money on them. There's no way to recover the lost funds. So it helps fill up perishable hotel rooms. And then the typical demographic for the Disney vacation, or for timeshares, is 55 and older, affluent, married. And that does not apply to Disney Vacation Club members. So that's how it works. So for my primary research, I decided to do some qualitative research. I decided to do semi-structured interviews, talking to people that self-identify as Disney Vacation Club members. I found these people on the internet, as we find all good things. The Diz is a huge blogging message board, crazy Disney fanatic website, and they have a whole message board dedicated to the Disney Vacation Club. And then there are tons of Facebook groups also for Disney fanatics. So I posted messages on there saying, contact me if you want to do an interview. And I got a couple of respondents, so I talked to those people and asked them a set amount of questions that I wrote ahead of time that were based on the literature and were looking to answer my research questions. Some of those questions could be, have you ever belonged to a timeshare program besides this? Would you consider buying into the same program if it wasn't Disney? Why did you buy into the Disney Vacation Club? And what other Disney products do you spend time on? So answering questions about timeshares and the Disney brand. And I did have a smaller sample size than I anticipated, but I did get some really good information from these people, and it was great to talk to them about their experience. And I transcribed the interviews I had. I looked for some repeating keywords. I found some different trends, some overall ideas, the impressions, and then I identified kind of the attitudes that these brand enthusiasts had towards Disney and timeshares. So the results, none of the people I interviewed were interested in any of the timeshares. None of them owned any other timeshares, none of them would consider any other timeshare programs. So that kind of leads me to believe that it's Disney. It's not the program necessarily, it's the brand that's really driving this program that they have. Some words that came up over and over again, quality and trust. So those would be some positive brand associations that these enthusiasts had. And a few of them mentioned repeated positive experiences. So they went to the parks, they went on a vacation, and it went really well, so they wanted to come back. They all heard a sales pitch at Disney, which they use to get people to buy into the program. Like I said, they'll give you fast passes, they'll give you a Disney gift card to get you to come into their office and hear their pitch and crunch numbers for you. A lot of times it's very convincing. And all of the people I interviewed had very positive impressions of the whole brand. So a lot of them have all the DVDs, their kids watch the movies, they have clothing, they have kitchen utensils, they might have different decorations in their house. So a lot of Disney freaks, they self-identified as. And as far as brand extensions, this was kind of a tough question to pose to people because a lot of people don't understand what I'm talking about anyway. But two things that people kind of were receptive to were other entertainment and leisure options. So If there were to be a Disney-branded airline to add to their vacation, or say a restaurant in their hometown that was operated by Disney, people would be kind of receptive to it. It was difficult to get people to think beyond travel and leisure with Disney, so that would be something I would consider looking into for further research. And since I did qualitative research here, for further research, I would look into quantitative research, so surveys or also focus groups, which would be qualitative. Ask more detailed questions about the brand extensions. So it is kind of difficult to measure the strength of a brand beyond the fact that these people spend, you know, thousands and thousands of dollars. So the brand extension questions could get some really interesting results if we look into specific examples of things that could be launched by Disney using a Disney brand. And I would definitely look at kind of wider demographics. I just had a very small sample of people that go on Disney message boards and are really love Disney. So not just fanatical consumers, I would definitely like to look into. And yeah, so this is me. I'm graduating now. With Mickey and me. I think we're doing questions for the end, I think. Yes? Okay. So, oh, you want a picture with the camera?